Well, we're out here at Elkhorn Launch Facility in Sacramento. We're going to be heading up the Sacramento River to, I think it's Moronas, about 20 miles up, 20 miles back, and then have lunch at the Alamar restaurant, which is right in this area near the launch ramp. Pretty nice day, a little cooler than I expected, but I think it'll warm up some too. I'll show you what's going on here. We're waiting for the boats to launch. Who's that?
That's one thing for sure. No, you can't take it with you. That's one thing for sure. Ain't nothing wrong with you, girl. T-bone shuffle can't be cured.
That was the end of the fun part of the cruise, at least for us. The engine died unexpectedly, and it could be restarted, but any time you tried to put it into gear, it would die. After 15 minutes or so of trying various fixes, with no success, two GSG members, Brett and Cheyenne, stopped by and said, asked us if we wanted a tow. I was out of options for quick fixes, and so I decided that I didn't want to keep them any longer, so we accepted the tow. They towed us to Veronas, about 10 miles downstream. There, they have a launch ramp there, so we put the Avalon at one of their docks. Lucia stayed with the boat, and I got in Brett and Cheyenne's boat, and we made a quick trip back to Elkhorn. At Elkhorn, I picked up my truck and a boat trailer, drove up to Veronas, recovered the Avalon, and came back to Elkhorn. The total recovery time, total time between the tow and all subsequent recovery efforts was a little over 2 hours. So by the time we got back to Elkhorn, we had missed lunch at the Alamar restaurant, and the rest of the club members were then recovering their boats. We did end up having some pizza there with Eddie and Mercedes in Sacramento, so we got food anyway. As for the problem with the engine, as I'm making this video, I haven't had time to investigate it. I've been spending my time working on our larger boat, the Sunliner, so my priority has been that boat, and when that's done, it's close. Then I'll get back to finishing the Avalon and finding out what's wrong with the engine.